Now and forever.
Now we praise you, Jesus.
You're so good. Father, we thank you, God. Your presence is heaven on earth for us. Your presence is our fortress. Your presence is where we stand, God. We thank you that we can worship you, that we can praise you in the midst of this season. And so, Father God, we uplift your praises right now in our homes, in our hearts, in our lives. Father God, would you come and encounter us right now? Meet us right here, right now. We just ask you, Father, let your heaven invade us. Open up the heavens over us, oh God. So we want to know you. We want to know you more. God, I want to know you more. I want to know you in a way that I've never known you before. Teach me who you are in this season that I could never learn in another season. Because God, I want you. I want you and I need you. There's nothing else that we could need more right now than you, Father God, for you are healing, you are joy, and you are our protection, and you are our blessing, and you are our encouragement and our boldness in the season. So, Father God, I pray that you would give us your word. Let your word be spoken into our heart this morning. That whatever is on your heart, impart it into our hearts. Let your heaven, let your presence be heaven to us right now, right here on this earth, as it is in heaven. We thank you. In Jesus Christ's holy name we pray. We all say, Amen.
弟兄姐妹，感谢神，让我们每一个月的第一个礼拜都有机会一起来领圣餐。
Brothers and sisters, we really thank God that we can take communion together once a month.
这个圣餐不是一个仪式，这个圣餐是主的吩咐，是一个命令。
To take communion is really not just some tradition, but it is God's heart for us and what He wants for us.
所以我们领圣餐其实是透过这个圣餐，我们跟主连接起来。
And so really to...Through this communion, we actually connect with God.
在我们领受这个圣餐之前，我读一段的经文，以赛亚书53:5.
So before we take the communion, I want to read a scripture with you, Isaiah 53:5.
哪知他为我们的过犯受害，为我们的罪孽压伤。因他受的刑罚，我们得平安；因他受的鞭伤，我们得医治。
Says, but he was pierced for our rebellion, crushed for our sins.He was beaten so we could be made whole. He was whipped so we could be healed.
上帝差他的独生儿子耶稣基督来到这个世界上，是来舍去他的生命的。
God gave his only son, and the reason he did was so that he can cover all of our sins.
耶稣来到这个世界上，不是要长大成人、结婚、成家立业、赚钱，变得有钱有地位。
Jesus didn't come to die on the cross so that we can maybe have a better life or to have the more wealth and more things that we could be, you know, find pleasure in.
上帝差他的儿子到耶稣基督来到这个世界上是 give away his life.
God sent his son to die on the cross was so that he can give away his life.
所以当耶稣在十字架上的时候
So when Jesus was on the cross,
他为我们的罪成了神的赎罪祭。
Jesus became an atonement for our sins.
因为罪必须满足神的公义。
Because sin needs to be justified in God.
所以上帝用的最宝贵的方式就是让他自己的儿子替代了我们。
And so God used the most precious way to...Send his son that he would replace us.
所以当耶稣在十字架上的时候
，and so when Jesus was on the cross,
神把他对人类的愤怒和刑罚全部都倒在耶稣的身上。
God took everything that was humanity's, whether it's humanity's sin or our mistakes and our brokenness, and he poured it upon Jesus.
所以耶稣替我们全部承担下来。
And so Jesus really took on that heavy weight of all the burden of our brokenness.
使我们信他的人不再被定罪。
So that anybody who believes in him will never have to be justified of their sin.
今天我们要一起吃这个饼，喝这个杯。
And so this morning we want to receive this cup and this bread.
我觉得这个饼跟杯都有一个很特别的意思在里面。
I feel like this bread and this cup has a very specific and special meaning.
在要做成这个饼之前，必须把那个麦子要压碎，要压破，要压成粉以后，才有办法做成今天的饼。
In order to create the bread, there must be a breaking of the whether it's the yeast or the wheat in order to produce the bread.
所以要做成这个饼，有一个压碎，有一个 crash 的过程。
And so, in order to develop this bread, there had to be a breaking, a crushing in order to develop it.
同样，要做成这个葡萄酒的时候，这个葡萄也是需要被 crash 被压榨过以后，它才能够变成酒的。
In the same way, the wine was also, it also needs to have a pressing and crushing and destroying in order to produce the wine.
这代表了耶稣为我们的缘故被压碎了。
This represents how Jesus was crushed and he was broken so that we can have.
所以原来被压碎的应该是我。
Originally, the one that was supposed to be broken and crushed was me.
但他替代了我们。
And yet Jesus took it on himself for me.
所以当我们吃这个饼的时候
So when we receive this bread,
就是让我们再一次在属灵里面有一个我们的身体被还原了被 return 到原来应该有健康的样式
And so when we receive this bread, we are actually in this process of being restored, returned to the original created order of God.
同样这个酒也是因为葡萄被压碎以后这个酒代表耶稣的血洗净了我们所有一切的罪。
And so in the same way, when the wine is crushed, it is also that Jesus's process of crushing would then produce the blood to cover us.
所以我要说，因为这个圣餐可以把咒诅变成一种祝福。
And so because of this communion, and so therefore we can take even our brokenness, and turn it into a blessing.
特别在这个疫情的过程当中
Especially during our pandemic.
我奉耶稣基督的名宣告耶稣的宝血赦免我们一切的罪
I want to declare that Jesus' body and blood will wash away all of our sins.
也医治我们所有一切的疾病
And then also heal every single illness and brokenness in us.
这时候让我们用感恩的心来吃主的饼
Let us have a thankful heart as we receive
Hallelujah.
God's bread.
Amen. 这个葡萄被压榨过以后被压碎以后
When the cup is, when the grape wine is crushed
正如耶稣的血为我们流出来
It represents Jesus' blood being flowing out for us
所以我们因着这个血我们被称为义 righteousness
And so with this blood that we have been restored to righteousness
让我们一起用感恩的心喝主的杯
Let us use a thankful heart as we receive this cup
主耶稣，我们感谢你。
God, we thank you.
谢谢你为我们压碎。
We thank you that you were crushed for us.
所以我们今天能够站在这里。
So that we can stand here today.
我们才有一个机会可以成为神的儿女。
And that we can have this opportunity to become the sons and daughters of Christ.
我们才有一条路可以跟神和好。
And so that we can have this path in which we can restore our relationship with God.
主啊，求你祝福每一个今天早晨领受这个饼跟杯的弟兄姐妹。
I want to bless everyone that has received this cup this morning.
祝福我们有健康的身体。
Bless us with a healthy body.
给我们有一个喜乐的心。
And to have a joyful heart.
给我们有永远的盼望。
And to have a hope forever.
奉耶稣的名祷告。
In Jesus Christ's holy name.
Amen. 亲爱的弟兄姐妹，感谢主，让我们今天早晨还能够在线上一起来相聚。
Brothers and sisters, we thank the Lord that we are still able to gather together even online as we have service and celebrate together.
过去的这几个礼拜我一直在祷告当中来寻求神要分享什么样的信息给各位。
In the last couple of weeks, I've been really praying, spending time to pray and ask the Lord what is on his heart to share with us as a congregation, brothers and sisters in our family.
那么在我祷告当的时候，有一个领受，神特别要我多注意在帖撒罗尼迦前书这卷书的里面。
Now, as I was praying, I received a revelation from the Lord, just that He wants to continue to speak through the scripture of 1 Thessalonians.
那我预备分成三篇的信息跟各位一起来分享。
And I want to split this up into about three different sermons, to share the heart of God with you.
今天我要分享疫情中神的旨意。
Today, what I want to share is God's will in the midst of a pandemic.
上个礼拜 Pastor Ming 有跟我们分享神的旨意是赐平安的，神的旨意不是降灾祸的。
Last week, Pastor Ming shared with us that God's will is to bring peace into our lives, not to bring calamity.
所以我们相信疫情不是神给的。
And so we believe that this pandemic is not from God.
也不是神的心里面所想的。
It is also not God's heart.That he wants it for us.
但是我们可以在这个疫情的过程和所发生的这一段的时间当中，我们可以学习到一些的事情，好叫我们的心可以再一次的转向神。
But in the midst of the pandemic, there are some things which we can learn about God and about His heart that can really help us to align with God in what He's doing.
所以我要在这里再一次lay down一个foundation，就是弟兄姐妹，我们要确信神的旨意。肯定是好的，是赐平安的。
And so I really want to use today's sermon to really lay down a firm foundation for us about how God and His heart is really to give us peace and to really be a good God for us.
好，我们一起来看《帖撒罗尼迦前书》第五章十六到十八节。这里说，保罗说，要常常喜乐，不住的祷告，凡事谢恩。因为这是神在基督耶稣里向你们所定的旨意。
So in 1 Thessalonians chapter 5, verse 16 through 18, it says this, Always be joyful, never stop praying. Be thankful in all circumstances, for this is God's will for you who belong to Christ Jesus.
好，我们看到一个英文的翻译是说，这是上帝给你的旨意。
In the English, it says that this is God's will for you.
但是在另外一个翻译里面，却翻译出来就是说，这是上帝给你一种生活的方式。
But there's another translation of the scriptures that actually says, this is the way that God wants you to live.
Wow, 这里所以我们就忽然间就很容易明白什么叫做神的旨意，就是神期待我们活出来应该有的样式。
And so through these scriptures, we can really understand that God's heart for us is, and the way that He wants us to live really is equivalent to God's will.
有很多人把神的旨意想得太复杂，想得太抽象。
Sometimes we take this phrase, God's will, and turn it into something a little bit complicated or a little bit abstract.
所以有一些基督徒就会说，牧师，我怎么样能够明白神的旨意？
And so some Christians will ask often, how do I even understand, how do I know what God's will is?
弟兄姐妹，神的旨意就是神期待你要怎么活。
Brothers and sisters, God's will is just simply how He calls us to live.
所以一个基督徒，如果我们勤读神的话，你自然就会知道神期待你我成为什么样的人。
So brothers and sisters, if you really look into the scriptures, not only will you discover God's will, but you will see how God calls us to live our lives.
所以换句话说，你是照世人的标准来活，还是你照神的标准来活？
In other words, what we're saying is, are you living your life in accordance to society or humanity's way, or are you living your life in accordance to the way that God calls us to live?
所以不可否认的，我们身为一个基督徒，有的时候我们好像我们的生活跟世人也没有什么太大的差别。
A lot of times as Christians, sometimes we don't realize that we are actually living in the way that society or humanity wants us to live, but there's no difference in how we live for Jesus.
简单来说，什么叫做照着世人的方式？简单讲就是像外邦人所求的一样。
In other words, to say that if we are living as the secular world is living, then we are in a way, we can translate that to saying that we are living like Gentiles.
耶稣在马太福音第六章有讲了几个比喻。
In the book of Matthew, Jesus gave us a couple of examples.
耶稣说人不能侍奉两个神，不是侍奉神就是侍奉马门。
God said, that we as people, we cannot serve two lords. And so if we don't serve our God in heaven, then really we have chosen to serve Mammon.
所以马门就代表的钱财。
Now Mammon, what that means or what that represents really is the spirit of money.
耶稣不是要我们不工作不赚钱。
And God's not saying that we're not supposed to work and earn a living.
耶稣要提醒的我们的是看重的是神还是看重的是金钱。
But rather God is saying, what do you value? Are you valuing God in your life as a standard or are you valuing the money?
我觉得这个次序如果放错了我们就有很多的忧虑在里面。
What I'm trying to say is that if our priority or order of orientation of value is improper, it's not the right orientation, then we've really lost track.
弟兄姐妹，如果我们真的相信神，我们知道神必眷顾我们，神也必供应我们一切的需要。
You see, in our faith, we have to believe that God is a God who not only takes care of us, but he provides everything that we need.
但如果我们所侍奉的是马门，那么 I guarantee you, 我们永远会觉得担心钱不够用，不够多，退休了怎么办？
But if in our hearts we really value the materialistic or the money things, then we'll find ourselves, no matter how much we earn, no matter what we do, we will always feel in lack of whether it's money or the things that we want.
耶稣也告诉我们说，不要忧虑吃什么、喝什么、还有穿什么。
Jesus said to us, don't worry about what you're going to drink, eat, or even what you wear.
意思简单来讲就是好像感觉到用的还不够好。
In other words, what that's saying is if you worry about these things, then what you have is really not enough for you.
这是耶稣说你们哪一个人可以用透过你的忧虑使你的岁数可以多增加几年。
Jesus said, how many of us can through worrying add an extra day to our lives?
那简单讲就是怕活得不够久。
In other words, what he's saying is that we fear not living long enough.
而我今天特别注意在那个岁数底下原文的圣经有几个小字在里面。
Now, in the scripture, I actually noticed a couple of subscripts.
那你说，那个岁数也同时指着身量有多少。
In the midst of all these discussions, that we even worry about how tall we are.
啊，这个就讲到我的内心了。
And when I read this, it really talked about my nature.
我以前一直很希望我能够有170公分、175公分，所以我常常担心我不够高。
I always dreamed and wished that I could be so and so tall, but I never met that standard, and so I always felt like I was never tall enough.
所以耶稣说，你的忧虑会是你再长一公分、再长一寸吗？
And so in this example, Jesus is really telling us that will your worrying help you to grow an inch?
所以各位为什么会有忧虑?
So brothers and sisters, why do we have worry?
因为我们总是希望拥有更多。
Because in our brokenness, we always wish to have more than what we have.
这就是耶稣所说的，这些都是外邦人所求的。
And this is what Jesus is talking about when he says that this is a lifestyle of the Gentiles and what they hope for.
但是如果我们先求神的国和神的义，神最终还是会把外邦人所求的那些东西赐给我们。
But the Bible tells us that if we value God and we put our hope and faith in Him, then even all the things that the Gentiles pursue in life, we will also be added into our lives.
我有遇见过一个姐妹。
I one time knew a lady.
她以前喜欢逛街买鞋买包包买名牌。
She loved to shop. She loved to buy shoes and purses and all these name brand things.
她告诉我她的鞋子都是名牌的鞋子就有五六十双。
And she told me that her really fancy name brand shoes has at least five or six pairs.
哇，名牌包包就有二三十个。
And her purses of name brand purses had like 20 to 30.
在她还没有信主之前，她非常追求这些。
And before she had come to know Jesus Christ, she very valued and pursued these things.
但是信主了以后，这些对她来讲已经不再是重要的。
But then all of a sudden, after she accepted Jesus as her Lord and Savior, all of these things became not important.
以前她觉得已经很多了，但是还是觉得不满足。
And so in the past, before she knew Jesus, even though she had so much, she still felt that she did not have enough. It wasn't satisfying.
但感谢主，她信了耶稣以后，她的生命有一个很大的改变。
But I really thank God that after getting to know Jesus, her life had a great transformation.
所以保罗在这里提醒我们三件事情是神的旨意。
So Paul really teaches us here that there are three things that really align with God's heart and will.
第一就是常常喜乐。
The first is to always be joyful.
第二，不住的祷告。
Secondly is to never stop praying.
第三，凡事谢恩。
And thirdly, to be thankful in all circumstances.
如果我们按照这样的方式来生活，我们就是行在神的旨意里。
If we live in accordance to this way, then we are then living in the will of God.
今天我要谈的第一个，常常喜乐。
The first thing I want to talk about is how to be cheerful always.
为什么我们需要喜乐？
Why do we need to be joyful?
第一个，因为我们的神是喜乐的神。
First is because our God is a God of joyfulness.
诗篇四十三篇第四节那里说，我就走到神的祭坛，到我最喜乐的神那里去。
In Psalms 43 verse 4 it says, There I will go to the altar of God, to God, the source of all my joy.
所以英文圣经说神是我喜乐的来源。
And because the Bible says that God is the source of all my joy.
弟兄姐妹，你看过我们的上帝沮丧过吗？你看到我们的上帝失望难过过吗？他有 depressed 过吗？
Brothers and sisters, have you ever seen or feel like God has ever been depressed or dissatisfied, discouraged?
圣经告诉我们，我们的神是最喜乐的神。
But rather, the Bible tells us that our God is the most cheerful and joyful God.
所以如果神是一位喜乐的神，他的教会，他的儿女应该是喜乐的。
And so if our God is always full of joy, then so his church and his sons and daughters ought to be.
感谢主，我们的天父爸爸是一个快乐的，是一个开心的神。
Wow, I'm very thankful that our Heavenly Father is a God who is full of joy, full of cheer.
所以其实坦白讲，主日崇拜我们的庆典，我们叫 celebration， 但是我感觉到有一些教会主日的时候好像在做追思礼拜一样。
You know, so when we have Sunday service, why do we call it a celebration? Because we are called to celebrate. But sometimes in churches, we take our Sunday services and turn them into this really dark, dark time.
所以弟兄姐妹，让我们在神的面前喜乐的来侍奉他。
And so I pray that we would all have the spirit and attitude that we come together to celebrate and be joyful with the Lord.
虽然我们现在没有办法大家聚在一起敬拜。
Although we may not be able to gather all together to have service.
但是你知道吗？每个礼拜牧师坐在我自己的家里面，我都是这样唱歌的来赞美神的。
How many of you guys know that me, when I'm at home, that I every Sunday, I'm there clapping my hands, being joyful, celebrating and singing praises.
我要赞美神是因为我的神是一个喜乐的神。
And I want to praise my God because my God is a God of joyfulness.
诗篇四十二篇第五节，诗人也这样告诉我说：“我的心啊，你为何忧闷？为何在我里面烦躁？应当仰望神，因他笑脸帮助我们，我们还要称赞他。”
In Psalms 42 verse 5, it says, "Why are you down in the dumps, dear soul? Why are you crying the blues?" Fix my eyes on God. Soon I'll be praising again. He puts a smile on my face. He is my God.
所以弟兄姐妹，现在在你家在你的家里面，你现在在忧虑什么？你在烦躁什么？你的心里面在不安什么？
Brothers and sisters, while you are at home, what is it that is frustrating you? What is it that's causing you to have anxiety and confusion in the midst of this time?
这里诗人告诉我们，我们应该要仰望神，因为神是用笑脸帮助我们的。
In the scripture, it's telling us that we need to turn our eyes to the Lord, fix our eyes on God, because He is the one that brings a smile to our face.
我喜欢英文的翻译说 ，He put a smile on my face. 他把笑脸放在我的脸上。
Yeah, He put a smile on my face.
所以弟兄姐妹，我们的神期待我们看到我们是欢喜快乐的。
And so, you know, I'm excited that God would see us and He would see that we are so excited.
为什么会有压力?
How come we have so much pressure?
为什么我们心里面烦躁不安?
Why do we have so much like conflict in our hearts?
有没有可能是我们想得的我们没有得到?
Is it perhaps because the things which we want so badly want,
我们该有的我们没有?
Is it because the things that we need, we don't have?
我们期待要来的没有来。
Is it because what we expect that we would get, we didn't get?
所以我们就失望，我们就失落。
And so then we became disappointed.
弟兄姐妹，有没有可能我们想要的太多了？
Perhaps is it because we have desired too much?
你看到在旧约圣经里面有一个先知叫哈巴谷，他曾经这样说：葡萄树不结果，无花果树不发旺，橄榄树也不效力，田间也不出粮食，圈中也结了羊，棚内也没有牛。但是他要因为耶和华欢喜快，他什么都没有，但是他因耶和华欢喜快乐。
How many of you guys know in the scripture there's this person called Habakkuk who said that even when the grape tree will not bear fruit or the fig tree or whatever tree will not bear fruit and yet still I will have my joy in the Lord.
所以弟兄姐妹，我们要喜乐的原因是因为我们的神是帮助我们的，而且他是一个喜乐的神。
And so brothers and sisters, we want to have a joyful heart because our God is a joyful God who helps us in the time of need.
第二，喜乐是我们的力量。
Secondly, is joy is our great strength.
一个人当他心里面有喜乐的时候，他做起什么事情来都觉得很顺利。
When a person is full of joy, no matter what he or she does, they are full of strength and full of just energy.
如果没有喜乐的时候，做什么事都就觉得啊，都不起劲。
But when you don't have joy, it seems that no matter what you do, it just feels like it is not enough, it's not good enough, and you just don't have the energy for it.
尼希米记第八章第十节里说，不要忧愁，因为靠耶和华而得的喜乐是你的力量。
And so in Nehemiah chapter 8 verse 10, it says, don't feel bad, for the joy of God is your strength.
Amen. 神是我们的力量。
Amen. God is our strength.
第三个，我们要喜乐的原因是因为喜乐是良药。
Thirdly, we want to be thankful because it is good for our health.
箴言书十七章第二十二节告诉我们，喜乐的心乃是良药，忧伤的灵使骨枯干。
In Proverbs chapter 17 verse 22, it says, "A cheerful heart is good medicine, but a broken spirit saps a person's strength."
哇，弟兄姐妹，你没有看到在这里圣经讲的？哎 ，joy, it's a good medicine.
The scripture tells us that joy is a good medicine.
另外一个翻译说，喜乐对我们的身体有健康有帮助。
Another translation says that joy is good for your health.
所以今天有很多人很紧张，很焦虑。
So today, there are many people who are very stressed out and just full of anxiety.
有的人很紧张。
A lot of people are full of pressure.
所以自然就会影响你的情绪。
And so very naturally, it will affect your attitude and your emotions. Emotion.
那你的情绪就会影响你的身体。
And so your emotions will naturally then affect your physical body.
上个礼拜我们都听到了 Eno 的见证。
Last week, we all heard Eno's testimony.
其中有两个人就讲到说 ,Eno 有一个最明显的记号就是他人还没有到他的笑声就到了。
There's two people who actually mentioned that one of the very beautiful characteristics of Eno is that before she even is seen, her physical presence is seen, we already hear her joyful cheers coming in.
所以怪不得她虽然身体还在软弱当中，这是因为她的喜乐就医治了她。
And so no matter whether her body is in weakness or in difficulty, but her joy actually brings her strength and gives her health.
我真的不知道为什么有一些人他们每一天都活得很不开心。
And so I really don't understand when sometimes there are some people who in every day they live in so much dissatisfaction.
如果这是你的话，我奉耶稣基督的名祝福你，求主今天把喜乐的灵赐下来在你的生命里面。
Now if that is you, I pray for you right now. I speak over you that this would break off of you, that from today on you will begin to live with the joy of the Lord.
我们当中如果有人在这个疫情的过程当中，你有很多的压力，有很多的担心，有很多的害怕，今天在这里我奉耶稣基督的名，今天早上就释放你的心，让主的喜乐充满在你的里面。
If you feel like you have been living in really downcast throughout this whole pandemic, then right now I want to pray for you. I want to pray that this would break off of your heart right now in Jesus Christ and you would find the joyful heart.
亲爱的新生命的家人们，不要忘记了，我们的神是一个喜乐的神。
New Life family, come join me as we remember that our God is a God of great joy.
为什么？那喜乐是什么？
Now, what is joyfulness?
喜乐是一种观点，喜乐是一种看事情的方法。
Joyfulness is actually a perspective. It is how you see things.
我常常讲，信得对就活得对。
If I often say, if you believe it right, then you will live it right.
你活得对，在你的情绪里面自然就稳定。
And so if you live it right, then naturally in every part of your inner being, it will be whole.
弟兄姐妹 我再说一次，信得对就活得对，活得对情绪就稳定。
And so、if you believe it right, then you live it right, and therefore what you live in right, it will then cause you to have this stability in you.
所以我要鼓励每一个弟兄姐妹，你要常常去读神的话语。
So brothers and sisters, I really want to encourage you to get into the word of God.
我们的信从哪里来？
Where does our faith come from?
我们的信就是从神的话来的。
Our faith comes from the word of God only.
所以当我们有了神的话作为我们的基础，我们自然在各方面就能够稳定下来。
And so when we have the word of God, our faith arises, and therefore in all things of our lives, we will find goodness.
特别在这个不确定的时代里面。
Especially during this unstable and uncertain time.
面对未来，没有人知道会是怎么样。
When we face the unknown,
但是弟兄姐妹，如果你读神的话，你就有一个 assurance， 你有一个确信在里面，因为神的话从来没有改变过。
But if you rest in the words of God, then you will know that you have an assurance that there is a constant in your life that nothing will change.
所以现在弟兄姐妹，我要鼓励你，不要到处问人家什么意见。我鼓励你先回到上帝的话里面，神一定会透过圣经。对我们每一个人说话。
So I really want to encourage you, you know, don't go and ask every person about their opinion, but rather go back to the word of God so that you can have a stability, a foundation in God.
Hallelujah!
Hallelujah!
我期待神的话成为一个活泼的道，在你我每一天的生活的里面。
I have this great expectation that God's word will become a lively word in our lives every day.
为什么喜乐是一种观点呢？
Why is joyfulness a perspective?
请我们一起来看希伯来书十二章第二节。
Let's look at Hebrews 12 verse 2.
那里说，仰望为我们信心创始成终的耶稣，他因那摆在前面的喜乐就轻看羞辱，忍受了十字架的苦难，便坐在上帝的宝座的右边。
It says we do this by keeping our eyes on Jesus, the champion who initiates and perfects our faith. Because of the joy awaiting him, he endured the cross, disregarding its shame, and now he is seated in the places of honor beside God's throne.
弟兄姐妹，你知道为什么我们会失去喜乐？
Brothers and sisters, do you know why we lose our joy?
因为当我们的眼目从耶稣的身上转移的时候，我们看到周围的环境，我们看到这个世界，我们的心里面就有很多的担心害怕。
Because when we take our eyes and do not fix them on Jesus, we take them off of Jesus, then all of a sudden, we look on the circumstances of our lives, and therefore we begin to have fear and lose that sense of joy.
所以希伯来书的作者在这里鼓励强调我们Keep on our eyes on Jesus. Hallelujah.
So right here in the scripture, it tells us, keep your eyes fixed on Jesus.
耶稣能够喜乐的原因是，因为他知道所忍受的一切最后会带来一个什么样的结果。
The reason that even Jesus was able to have joyfulness as he endured the cross is because he knew that the outcome of what he was about to walk into was beautiful.
耶稣被钉在十字架绝对不是一件快乐的事情。
You know, when Jesus went and was nailed to the cross, it most definitely was not a joyful moment.
当人家用钉子把他穿过他的时候，那是一件很痛苦的事情。
When the Roman soldiers put a nail through Jesus' hands, it is not a moment where you normally would celebrate.
人家用枪戳他的肋旁，那是一件 suffer， 那是一件非常痛苦的事情。
When the soldiers took a spear and speared the side of the ribs of Jesus, that is not a moment where you celebrate and are filled with joy.
虽然肉体在承受很多的痛苦。
And yet, even though our physical body or Jesus' physical body is suffering,
但弟兄姐妹，你没有注意到这里圣经说，耶稣在那个时候，他在他里面有一股喜乐在里面。
But here the Bible tells us that regardless of what was happening in his body, he still endured the cross with joy awaiting him.
所以，因为这一个喜乐，就可以使他轻看。 不在乎这些外在所受到的困难。
And so it's because of the joy which he was fixed on that it did not affect that the circumstances around him or it, that he was in did not affect him.
所以如果要有喜乐的话，保啊这个希伯来书的作者这里第二个英文的圣经里说 ，study how he did it， 耶稣是怎么做得到的。
And so here in the English, there's a translation here in the scripture that says to study how Jesus did it.
这里说 because he never lost sight. 他从来没有把他的眼光放在错的地方。所以亲爱的弟兄姐妹，喜乐是一种观点，是一种看法。
And so brothers and sisters, joy is our perspective.
如果受苦没有目的，那么那个受苦就白受的了。
The reality is, if we have suffering and the suffering has no purpose, then we suffer for no reason.
但是如果你受苦是有目的，这个受苦就会带来喜乐。
But if you're in your suffering, you discover a purpose in that suffering, then you actually will discover a joy from that.
要成为一个好的运动员，每天早晨四点就要起来运动，哇，要做很多的这个练习，是很辛苦。但是他知道，如果经过这样，他可能可以得到。可以成为一个杰出的运动员，那个苦就会带来喜乐。
For example, someone who works out, somebody who works out is constantly waking up in the morning with this pursuit to really cause their bodies to suffer. But when they suffer, they know that the outcome of that suffering is something that brings them great benefits, and therefore they find the joy in that suffering.
农夫要撒种，农夫要除草，农夫要做很多的事情，但是他如果看到未未来的那个丰收，他的里面就有个喜乐，就可以忍受这一切的过程跟他的辛苦。
The same goes for farmers. You see, when farmers have to go plant their crops, there's a lot of tedious, hard work, hard labor, that really is painful and suffering. But they know that when they plant these crops, there is a great harvest in which they will find later on, and so therefore they have great joy in their sowing.
所以弟兄姐妹，喜乐不是使痛苦消失。
And so, the joy is really not equivalent to what our suffering is.
喜乐也不是所有的事情都照着你的想法如你的意你就能喜乐。
Joy is also not just because, oh, whatever circumstance that you have and therefore you will somehow gain that joy.
弟兄姐妹，喜乐是你的眼光，是你看事情的方式。
Brothers and sisters, I say again that your joy is simply how you perceive things.
喜乐不只是一种感觉。
Joy is not just some feeling.
如果你只是依靠感觉，那 I guarantee, 我保证你，你的心情每一天就是 up and down.
If we really only rely on our emotions and how we feel, then every day will be an up and down roller coaster.
同样的，四个多月过去了。
At the same time, we have passed through 4 months of this pandemic.
我们在这个疫情当中，你是得到祝福，还是你觉得你还在等，等什么时候这个疫情会过去？
Let me ask you, now that it's been 4 months,Are you still waiting for your moment of breakthrough or joy? Or are you already moving on?
如果你还在等这个疫情，弟兄姐妹，你在浪费时间。
If you're still waiting for whatever is going to happen with this pandemic, then brothers and sisters, you've really lost track.
我相信有一些人会在这一次的疫情当中会有很多的成长，甚至突破，而且有喜乐。
I really believe that in the midst of this pandemic, that there are a lot of brothers and sisters who will grow and be empowered, equipped in many ways, and so they will find their joy and they will find their breakthrough.
第二个，喜乐是一个决定，是一个态度，不是感觉。
Secondly, joy is really an attitude. Again, it is not an emotion.
腓立比书第四章第四节，保罗说：“你们要靠主常常喜乐。”我再说，你们要喜乐。
In Philippians chapter 4, verse 4, it says, Always be joyful, full of joy in the Lord. So I say it again, rejoice.
弟兄姐妹，保罗在这里说，我再说一次 ，Come on, 腓立比的教会，我再说，你们要喜乐。
Here, Paul is, this is how Paul is saying it. Paul is saying to the Philippians, saying, Listen, guys, be joyful again. Come on, let me say it again. Again, be joyful again. Rejoice.
所以换句话说，保罗讲的再讲，讲的再讲。
And so what it's saying in the scripture is really Paul is saying it over and over and over again.
我相信那个时候腓立比的教会可能正在经历一些的患难。
I believe that in that time, the Philippian church must have been going through some serious suffering.
有一些人失去了他们里面的平安跟喜乐。
Maybe some of those people in that church had actually lost their peace.
但是呢，保罗在这里说，我说你们要喜乐。
And yet Paul still says to them, you have to remember to rejoice.
但是可能有一些人告诉我说，牧师，我就是喜乐不起来嘛。
Now some people might say to me, well, pastor, I just can't figure out how to get my joy out.
弟兄姐妹，我告诉你，你如果你要靠你自己，你是不可能喜乐起来的。
But brothers and sisters, I want to say, if you are relying on yourself to find that joy and to experience that joy, then you will never find it.
如果你看着到处的疫情，特别在南加州疫情人，这个得病的人、死去的人越来越多，你根本就喜乐不起来的。
And if you're looking at the pandemic and all the circumstances around us and the world and everything going on, then the truth is you will most definitely not find the joy.
那保罗在这里说，不是你自己，保罗说要靠主常常喜乐。弟兄姐妹，如果不靠主，我们是喜乐不起来的。
And so Paul, that's why he says here, listen, you need to be full of joy in the Lord, rely on the Lord, because in the Lord is where we find our rejoicing.
所以弟兄姐妹，保罗怎么能够在自己也被放在罗啊那个腓立比的监狱的里面，但是他能够写出一个喜乐的一篇的书信
？And so no wonder we see Paul, even though he was locked up in Philippi's jail cell, yet Paul still had so much joy to praise the Lord.
因为保罗深深的了解，喜乐是一个决定，是一个态度。
Because for Paul, he knew that his joy was an attitude, a decision in his attitude.
因为保罗决定在各种患难困难的环境里面，他保持一个健康，保持一个喜乐的心态。
So Paul, in the midst of his difficulties, he made a commitment, a conviction in his heart to decide to protect his joy no matter what happens.
我告诉你一个喜乐的秘诀。
Let me tell you a secret about joy.
如果你真的想要有喜乐的人生，
if you really want to have joy in your life,
那么你就多想一天，多想一些让你可以喜乐的事情。
Then you really need to ponder upon things which bring you joy.
简单讲就是多看一些正面的、积极的、美好的。
In other words, a simpler way to say that is to dwell upon, meditate upon things that are positive in your life.
腓立比书第四章第八节，保罗说：“弟兄们啊，我还有未尽的话。凡是真实的、可敬的、公义的、清洁的、可爱的、有美名、有什么德行、有什么称赞，这些你们都要思念。”
If you look down at a couple of scriptures, Philippians chapter 4, verse 8, it says, "Now, brothers and sisters, one final thing I want to say: fix your thoughts on what is true and honorable and right and pure and lovely and admirable. Think about things that are excellent and worthy of praise."
保罗在这里讲了好几个，哇，这个是啊，怎么样？真实的、可敬的，哇，都是正面，都是好的。
Look at how Paul lists out all of these very positive things. He says the true, the honorable, the right, and the pure, and the lovely, admirable.
哇，弟兄姐妹，我们就忽然间看到保罗在这英文圣经说 ，fix your thought 啊，把你的思想、把你的意念放在一些正确的、正面的事情上。
So Paul here really tells us the instructions of how to do this. He says, fix your thoughts on these things.
所以弟兄姐妹，我不是要你不看新闻，但是如果是那些负面的新闻，可以不要再看了。
And so brothers and sisters, what I'm telling you is that I'm not saying to not go watch the news, but what I'm saying is if that news is a negativity in your life, then stop looking at it.
在疫情的这几个月里面，我每天都花很多的时间也看各种不同的报道。
During this pandemic, I looked at all different types of announcements and things.
但是上个礼拜在祷告会的时候，神就告诉我 quit, 叫我戒掉看这些负面的新闻。
But as I was praying last week in the middle of prayer meeting, all of a sudden I heard the Lord speak to me and he said, stop it. He said, stop looking at all the negative news and announcements.
过去的一个礼拜，我连一个新闻我都没有看。
And so in this last week, there was not a single news that I want to go fix my eyes.
感谢主，我们都还活得好好的。Hallelujah.
Thank God, even though I don't look at the news, I'm still alive and living well.
我宁可多花一点时间多看神的话。
I'd much rather spend the time that I spent on news reading the Word of God.
我宁可多花一些时间默想神的美好。
I would much rather spend that time meditating upon the goodness of my Father in heaven.
弟兄姐妹，你知道你为什么会跟你的配偶结婚吗？
Brothers and sisters, do you know why that somebody would marry their spouse?
你还记得当时你们急着要结婚吗？
If you're married, do you remember the time when you were just about to get married?
为什么那个时候你很想娶她，或者是你很想嫁给她？
Do you remember the reason why you chose to be engaged to that person?
因为那个时候你想他的都是好的。
Because when you saw that person, everything about them was good.
哇，不论如何，我不可以失去他。
And so no matter what happens, I do not want to, I don't want to lose this wonderful person.
我用尽各样的办法就是要把它保留下来。
And so I will use every effort that I can to draw that person close to keep them in my life.
因为说你不管想什么你都是想好的。
Because no matter what you see about them, you see the goodness in them.
是最后你们结婚。
And so in the end, you fell in love and married.
那结婚久了以后为什么有些人要离婚呢？
But then how come after years that some people then go and decide to divorce?
因为现在想那都是他不好的。
Because all of a sudden our perspective has changed, and all we can think about is all the negative things that they do.
弟兄姐妹，如果你要让你的婚姻兴盛起来，想他的好 ，Amen.
Brothers and sisters, if you want your marriage to be alive again, then you really need to fix your thoughts on all the wonderful things about your spouse.
你越想他的好，他就越变越好。
The more that you perceive them in the goodness that they are, the more that they will become a good spouse to you.
你自己也变得很喜乐。
And so then you will find yourself so joyful in your marriage.
你讲出来的话都是祝福的话。
And everything that you say to them is a word of blessing to them.
你对他的态度都是好的。
And your attitude towards them is always good.
因为你想的都是他的好嘛。
Because everything that you think of them is wonderful and cheerful.
在这段疫情的当中，你们的关系怎么样
？Brothers and sisters, in the midst of your in this pandemic, how are your relationships like?
所以我要鼓励各位，保罗说他的秘诀就是他 always 想那些神要他想的。
So brothers and sisters, Paul's secret is to fix his thoughts.
弟兄姐妹，我要告诉你，如果你一天到晚在跟别人比较，你是不可能有喜乐的。
Brothers and sisters, also another truth is that if you're constantly comparing yourself with others, then you will never find joy.
你一天到晚只在乎别人说什么，你神要你专注在你现在有的是什么。
Because brothers and sisters, when you compare, you will always value what other people say about you.
弟兄姐妹，有人说腓立比书是一本充满喜乐的书。
And the Bible, a lot of people say that this chapter in the Bible, Philippians is full of joy.
如果你去看腓立比书，你真的知道那里面有很多喜乐的秘诀在里面。
Now, if you go and look in that scripture, part of scripture, you will find all the secrets of joy.
我就讲一点，腓立比书里面保罗说要看别人比自己强。
I'll share one secret that's in there. It says that when you look at people, you have to see that that they are stronger than you.
换句话说，一天到晚想自己的人永远不会快乐的。
In other words, what that scripture is saying is whoever is constantly is constantly trying to figure out how well they're doing will never find joy.
所以怪不得有的人会觉得为什么我配偶不对我这样我的配偶不对我那样你一天到晚集中在自己想自己你是不会快乐的。
And so no wonder a lot of people are disappointed in their spouse or disappointed in that relationship because they are always, their eyes are always fixed on their selfishness.
圣经告诉我们看别人比自己强。
The Bible tells us to look at others and honor them as somebody greater than you.
所以换句话说不要拿自己跟别人一天到晚做比较。
In other words, you don't need to go and compare yourself with others.
哇他的收入比我好。
That somebody else's, you know, income is better than mine.
哇，他开的车比我好。
That somebody else's car is better than mine.
哇，他住的房子比我大。
That somebody else's house is better than mine.
哇，他的工作比我好。
That his work is better than mine.
哇，他的恩赐比我强。
That their anointing is stronger than mine.
如果这是我们的态度的话，我们不会有喜乐的。
If this is our attitude, then we will never find joy.
所以各位，求上帝帮助我们。喜乐是一种决定，是一种态度。
And so, we need to remember that our joy is in the midst of our perspective and our decision.
一个人如果不要只顾及自己的事，也顾别人的事，这个人一定是一个喜乐的人。
Someone who is not only concerned with themselves and therefore comparing with others, but actually concerned for somebody else, then that is someone who will definitely find joy.
弟兄姐妹，如果你要成为一个喜乐的人。
Brothers and sisters, if you want to be someone with joy,
你要为你所拥有的感谢神。
You need to be thankful for all the things that you have.
你拥有神的救恩。
And you have the salvation of Christ.
你成为神的儿女。
You have the sonship of Christ.
你是有使命的。
You have a destiny in Christ.
所以你为这些来感谢神。
And so you can be thankful for
不要只是在乎，不要只是在乎别人有这个有那个。
Don't just be, don't look at others and see what they have and what you don't have.
也不是在乎你身上，你的身边拥有多少东西。
Not to be constantly concerned about whether you have or have not something.
或者你可以享受这个，可以享受那个。
Or whether you can enjoy this or enjoy that.
这个礼拜我看到一句话，我觉得很有意思。他说，享乐可能跟喜乐有关，但是喜乐绝对不是取决于享乐。
And so this week I saw a quote that I thought was very, very powerful. It says, pleasure could be associated with joy, but joy is not dependent on our pleasures.
所以为什么是一种态度呢？
So no wonder it is an attitude.
我们来看雅各书第一章第二节到第四节那里，雅各说，我的弟兄们，你们落在百般的试炼中要以为大喜的，因为知道你们的信心经过试验就生忍耐，忍耐也当成功，使你们成全完备，毫无缺欠。Wow.
In James chapter 1, verse 2 through 4 says, Dear brothers and sisters, when troubles of any kind come your way, consider it an opportunity for great joy. For you know that when your faith is tested, your endurance has a chance to grow. So let it grow, for when your endurance is full, developed, you will be perfect and complete, needing nothing.
弟兄姐妹，雅各在这里告诉我们，我们在各样的患难里面要大喜的，哇，这是一个不得了的事。
James here is telling us that we need to beConsidering every situation, even difficult situations, as an opportunity for great joy.
所以弟兄姐妹，你有没有看到英文圣经里面是 consider， 在这种困难的里面，其实是一个绝佳的机会，可以得到一个喜乐。
And so this scripture is telling us that even our troubles, our difficult situations, are an opportunity for joy.
为什么在困难中可以有机会喜乐呢？
And so how come in the midst of our suffering, we can discover joy?
容许我这样说，困难是我们经历神最好的机会。
Perhaps it's because difficulties is the greatest opportunity for us to discover God's joy.
所以我们在患难中，我们懂得依靠神，我们就会发现神所赐给的远远超过我们所求所想的。
You see, when we, in the midst of our difficulties, go and rely on God and seek Him in our joy, then we will find that there is a great abundance of all the things that we hope for.
因为圣经在这里告诉我们说, your endurance has a chance to grow. 所以换句话说, 困难同时也是我们生命成长的时候。
In the scripture here, it says that your endurance through that difficult time is your chance to grow.
这就是为什么我说在疫情的过程当中有一些人真的成长了。
And so this is why I say that in the midst of the pandemic, there are a lot of people who right now are growing.
这几个月来我们听到教会不管哪一个牧区都有很多弟兄姐妹他们的见证我真的很得激励就是我发现他们在属灵的生命上都有很大的成长。
Recently, in all three of our church campuses, we've heard different testimonies and stories of people in the midst of the pandemic. And what I have discovered is that every single one of them who relies on the Lord finds that they have been empowered, uplifted in the midst of the pandemic.
所以在这里英文圣经又说 endurance, your endurance is fully developed. 哇不单如此。不单是只是有喜乐，不单是有成长，而且会提升他们，会发展新的东西出来。
And so when the scripture says that when your endurance is fully developed, then you will be perfect and complete. And so it's really just developing everything that you have ever expected, and it really gives you the full abundance of what you hope for.
弟兄姐妹，这并不代表我们在困难中我们不会难过，我们不会伤心，我们不会流眼泪。
Now, what this is not saying is that you will not feel sorrow or mourn or feel sadness in the midst of difficulties.
但是这些的困难，这些的挑战，不会影响我们生命里面那份的喜乐。
But these sad times, these mournful times, these difficulties, they have no ability to influence the joy that we perceive.
就像在这段疫情的期间。
And just so...Just like right now in the midst of our pandemic,
Eno 的爸爸妈妈都被主接回天家。
Eno's mom and dad both went back to heaven.
我父亲也被主接回天家。
My dad also passed away and went to heaven.
还有刘秀姐妹啊，她的妈妈也被主接回天家。
Also, Leo's sisters also had a family member that passed away and went to heaven.
这段时间我们都没有办法陪在他们的身边。
And during this time, we weren't able to be there for our family members.
虽然我们也流泪，我们也会难过。
And even though we may be sorrowful and mourn for them,
但是我们的内心里面却有一份从神而来的喜乐跟平安。
But yet in our hearts, we have this portion of joy from the Lord.
因为我们确信，将来有一天在主那里，我们会与他们见面。
And this peace in our heart.Comes from the fact that we know one day we will have a chance to reunite with them in heaven.
所以彼得鼓励我们。
So Peter encourages us.
在试炼当中是一个非常好成长的机会。
That in the midst of the trials, it will show that we have a great opportunity.
因为试炼会发展我们的性格，我们的 character.
Because these trials will actually develop our character.
会培养我们的 perseverance, 我们的毅力。
It will nurture our perseverance and our strength.
所以使我们整个的生命会变得更有力量。
And so that in our entire lives, we have great strength overall.
所以弟兄姐妹不要以为只有你有困难。
And so brothers and sisters, don't think that you are alone, that you are the only one suffering.
我们每一个人都面对不同的困难。
Every person is facing different types of difficulties.
但是你能不能成长，你能不能喜乐完全是出于我们自己的决定。
But whether you are using it as an opportunity to grow and find joy really depends on you.
最后我要说，喜乐是可以每一天的。
And lastly, what I want to say is joy is for every day.
好，我们来读最后一段的经文，诗篇十六篇第十一节，这里说：“你必将生命的道指示我，在你面前有满足的喜乐，在你右手中有永远的福乐。”
In Psalms chapter, and says, You will show me the way of life, granting me the joy of your presence and the pleasures of living with you forever.
大卫在这里告诉我们为什么他能够充满喜乐，而为什么他的生命里面充满神各样的祝福。
Here, David is really explaining to us how and why he is filled with joy and pleasures in every day.
我特别注意到英文圣经说 granting me the joy of your presence.大卫知道神的同在会带来一种喜乐。
In this English scripture, it says that David says, "Grant to me the joy of your presence," because David knew that God's presence always produces joy.
所以弟兄姐妹，当神的同在的时候，当神的同在临到，我们一无所缺。
And so when God's presence is with us, all things are well.
当神的同在来到的时候，那些世界的人所追求的，神一样都会加给你。
The minute that God's presence is with us, even the things that the worldly people pursue, God will still add to your life.
所以换句话说，大卫在这里告诉我们一个喜乐的秘诀：第一，就是先享受神，然后再享受他所赐给你的一切。
And so David's really telling us a secret is to go and pursue God first, and then God will therefore.Bring all things that we desire into our lives.
有些人说，牧师啊，我怎么知道神有没有同在啊？
Now, brothers and sisters, you might say, how do I know if God's presence is with us?
弟兄姐妹，神无处不在。
Brothers and sisters, God's presence is never not with us.
圣经告诉我们说 ，He's omnipotent. 他是无所不在，任何一个地方，你在家里，你在工作，你在开车，任何一个地方，神都与我们同在。
The Bible tells us that God is omnipresent. No matter whether you are driving at work or at home, He is always with us.
的问题不是他有没有同在。
The problem is not whether God is with us.
重点是我有没有 reposition， 我有没有对齐这个神。
The real question is, are we really positioned and aligned to have God's presence.
所以我觉得神的同在永远不是问题。
And so God's presence is never our problem.
问题是我们把自己的位置有没有放对来对齐这个神。
The real issue is, are we positioned correctly to be in God's presence?
所以大卫能够喜乐的原因在这里告诉我们，在中文的圣经里面他就说，因为神与他同在。
And in the scripture, David is saying that he can have joy because God's presence is with him.
诗篇第十六篇第八节第九节那里，大卫这样说：“我将耶和华摆在我的面前，因他在我右边，我便不致摇动。因此，我的心欢喜，我的灵快乐，我的肉身也要安然居住。” Wow, hallelujah.
Psalm 16, verse 8 through 9 says, I know the Lord is always with me. I will not be shaken, for he is right beside me. No wonder my heart is glad and I rejoice. My body rests in safety.
弟兄姐妹，什么叫做把神摆在面前
？Brothers and sisters, what does it mean to put God before you?
就是大卫常常借着读经、借着祷告、借着默想、借着聆听，让神的同在一直在他的周围。
It's to be like David, to always constantly have God's word before your eyes, praying, praising, and always aligning with Him.
所以他说 ，My heart is glad. 我的心是充满快乐的。
So no wonder David says, "My heart is glad."
所以，亲爱的弟兄姐妹，不要因着这个疫情的缘故，我们在那里担心害怕。
So brothers and sisters, don't rely on what will happen in the pandemic, because it will only bring us great fear.
我们的心也不要因为将来可能要来的经济的危机，心里面有很多的恐慌。
Also, do not let what may happen in the future with all this crisis to give you really a sense of fear.
如果我们常常把神摆在我们的面前
，But rather, if we are always putting God before us.
我再说一次，把神摆在我们的面前。
I want to say it again. Put God before you.
让上帝的同在围绕在我们的周围。
Let God's presence surround you.
我们就可以靠主，每天都有喜乐的心。
Then we can lean on Christ and have joy for every day.
神是喜乐的，他的儿女也应该是喜乐的。
So God is full of joy, and so His sons and daughters should have joy.
神的喜乐是我们每一天的力量。
God's joy is our everyday strength.
不单如此，神的喜乐是best, the best medicine, 最好的良药。
No matter what the truth is, Jesus' joy is our greatest medicine.
所以求主改变我们看事情的方法。
So I pray that God would change our perspective.
每天我们都做一个决定。
And that every day we can make a decision.
我要靠主喜乐。
That I will lean on Christ to find joy.
愿上帝祝福我们的教会。
May God bless all of our church.
也祝福每一个弟兄姐妹的家庭。
And bless every brother and sister's home.
我们一起来祷告。
Let us pray.
亲爱的天父，我们感谢你。
Dear God, we thank you.
因为你是喜乐的神。
Because you're a God of joy.
因为你住在我们的里面。
Because you live within us.
现在我奉耶稣基督的名祝福我们每一个人都可以靠主喜乐。
Right now, I want to bless everyone that every person can find the ability to lean on Christ's joy.
主啊，我奉耶稣基督的名，求你折断所有的heavy yoke这些的重轭在我们的身上。
I pray, Lord, that you would break off all of the heavy yokes upon us.
有一些人在恐惧的里面。
And especially those who are in the midst of fear.
有一些人在担心的里面。
And then those who are in the midst of great worry.
面对未来有很多的不确定性。
When we are facing a lot of uncertainty and unknowns,
主，我求你今天早晨把一个喜乐的灵放在我们的里面。
Yet this morning I speak that every person would receive the spirit of joy in us.
若是天上的飞鸟都不担心，主，我们也不担心。
God, if even the birds of the air do not worry, then so we will not worry.
如果地上的百合花你都给他们装扮，我们相信我们需要的神也会供应我们。
If God, you have made every flower on the earth beautiful, then so you will also bring beauty into our lives.
求你把这个盼望放在我们每一个人里面。
And so I pray that you would give us this hope into every single one of our lives.
奉耶稣基督得胜。
In Jesus Christ's holy name.
Amen. Amen. 愿神祝福各位。
God bless everybody.
弟兄姐妹平安。
Hey brothers and sisters, how are you?
要到我们大家庭的时间了。
It's our big family time together.
欢迎大家礼拜二晚上七点半到 Santa Ana Campus 来参加。
On Tuesday nights, we still have our on-site prayer meeting. So we want to welcome and invite you at 7:30 on Tuesday nights to come down to Santa Ana and join us for a revival prayer meeting.
我们原来预定今天的实体聚会呢，因为我们器材还没到，跟人力还不足，所以我们暂时先延后。
We are still planning for the on-site services, but because we have a delay in equipment and also we're still trying to recruit and find volunteers, and so we're going to have to push back our reopening just a little bit.
等我们一切都预备好了，我们会再通知大家，希望能够把最好的呈现给你。
And when we have prepared all of these things from equipment to the personnel and people to run everything, we will announce and let you know when we are open.
我们现在还是维持我们周日用预录的，然后直播，也谢谢大家的体谅。
We will continue to record services and have them available online. And so thank you everyone for your great efforts and everybody that's working behind the scenes.
请大家继续为我们所需要的设备跟人力资源来代祷。我们也相信神一定会为我们预备。
I ask you, would you help us to pray, to pray for just really the people that we need, the volunteers and the equipment and just everything involved with resources and things to help us to open. Please pray for those things. Thank you.
我们还是继续要预备，我们重新启动，重新开启，所以还是欢迎愿意来参加服事的弟兄姐妹们能够一起来参与。
Now we will still take every necessary step to begin to prepare for this reopening. So we invite anybody who is right now ready to serve to come to the on-site preparations and our recording so that you can get to learn and be a part of our process.
跟大家报告一个好消息，八月我们有一个很棒的讲座。
Now I want to update you on a really exciting news. In August, we have an awesome speaker to come and share in a workshop.
清华大学教授蔡仁松教授要来跟我们分享。
There is a professor from Taiwan, his name is Professor Tai, and he's going to be sharing with us.
八月十二号礼拜三晚上，他跟我们分享亲密的冲突。
On August 12th, that is a Wednesday at night, we will be having Professor Tai to share with us about intimacy.
另外在八月十六号周日的早上十一点，我们也会透过线上 Zoom 跟大家分享不完美的医治这个主题。
And also on August the 16th at 11 a.m. on Zoom, we will also be having another group that's gathering to share about imperfect healing.
所以蔡教授他跟他的夫人创建的这个佳美生命协会。
And this professor is part of the Wonderful Life Association.
他对台湾的年轻人有很大的影响。
And he has a lot of influence in the young people in Taiwan.
请大家预备，我们会到时候给大家更多的消息通知。
And so we will update you more as things get closer.
你有参加小组吗？
I'm wondering, are you joining in a cell group right now?
如果没有，我们非常欢迎你来参加我们各个地方的线上小组。
If you're not joining in a cell group, we really want to invite you to get involved, get engaged by joining some of our online small groups right now.
我们欢迎你到我们的网站去看我们教会的现在有的小组。
If you go onto our website, you will find a link where you can connect with all of the present small groups.
你也可以透过 email 来跟我们联系。
You can also email our admin email to communicate with us about connecting with a small group.
如果你是新朋友，我们非常欢迎你。
If you are a newcomer, new attendant to our church, we really welcome you.
请你透过这个二维码来跟我们告诉我们更多你的消息，我们会跟你联络。
We want to invite you to use the QR code and scan your information in so that we can get to know you, and we'd love to invite you to get to know us.
如果你有什么祷告上的需要，欢迎你也透过线上的二维码来跟我们联系，我们很乐意来跟你一起祷告。
Also, if you are in need of a prayer, if you have a prayer request, we want to encourage you to also use this QR code because you can actually submit a prayer request.
好，这段疫情时间很多人都在家种菜。
During this pandemic, a lot of people are planting their own vegetables from home.
感谢神，我也吃到很多弟兄姐妹带来的很好吃的，他们院子里头种的新鲜的菜。
I'm really thankful that I've had the opportunity to eat some of these wonderful veggies that have been grown from different brothers and sisters' homes.
非常谢谢他们的爱心。
I really thank all of the brothers and sisters for your love and care.
这让我想到箴言书三章九到十节这样说。
This reminds me of Proverbs chapter 3 verse 9 and 10 that says,
你要以财物和一切出熟的土产尊荣耶和华。
It says in verse 9, honor the Lord from your wealth and from the first of all your produce.
这样你的仓房必充满有余，你的酒榨有新酒盈溢。
So that your barns will be filled with plenty and your vats will overflow with new wine.
以我们的财物跟出熟的果子来尊荣耶和华。
Let us use our wealth and also our first produce to honor our God.
这是神的教导。
This is a teaching from the scriptures of God.
我们用敬拜来尊荣神。
And we use our praises, our worship, to honor our Lord.
我们遵守神的话语来尊荣神。
We also submit to God's word and obey His word as a way to honor our Lord.
我们也把神赐给我们的产业跟财物来尊荣神。
We also take all the provisions that God has given us through wealth or from our work that we can use to honor our Lord.
我们不是来跟神交换。
We are not here to exchange with God.
乃是这是神所应许给我们的祝福。
But rather, this is really the blessing that we are able to step into because of God.
当我们爱他，愿意把我们有的来献给他，尊荣他。
When we love Him, we take what we have and we use it to honor our Lord.
神是爱我们的父。
God is a loving Father towards us.
他也乐意把他所有的来祝福我们。
He also very fervently takes everything that He has to bless us and shower upon us.
我们同样的，在荧幕上有三种奉献的方式，也请大家能够透过这三种方式来奉献祝福教会。
And once again, you'll see on the screen that there are three different ways that we can all sow into the kingdom. And so use these three different options so that you can give your tithe and offering to the Lord.
也请为我们祷告，让我们能够做神财务上的好管家，来建造他的教会。
Also, if you would just pray for us as a church that we would be good stewards of all the things that God has given us and that we have provided for the Lord.
谢谢你。
Thank you.
让我们一起来为奉献祷告。
Let us pray for our tithe and offering.
亲爱的阿爸父，我们感谢赞美你。
Oh, beloved Father, we thank you.
我们一切所有的都是从你而来。
All things that we have are from you.
我们谢谢你的恩典。
We thank you for your grace.
谢谢你今天教我们要把财物跟一切出手的土产都拿来尊荣你。
I thank you, Lord, that you have called us to use our wealth and our produce to sing over the families who right now are struggling, whether in their finances or in their work.
求神你加倍的恩待祝福他们。
And I pray, Father God, that there would be a multiplication and increase of blessing for them.
当他们把那像寡妇两小钱献上的时候。
And I pray that just like the widow with two mites who came to give all that she had,
你要倾倒天上的福气。大大的来赐福于他们。
That the response from heaven, our Father in heaven, is to greatly, greatly shower down provisions and blessings for them.
你亲自要供应他们一切所需要的。
You provide all things that we need.
因为你是耶和华以勒供应我们一切需要的神。
Because you are Jehovah, the one who provides, the God who knows all we need.
我们谢谢你。
We thank you, Jesus.
奉耶稣基督的圣名祷告。
In Jesus Christ's holy name we pray.
Amen. Amen.
直到那